everyone. So welcome back to my channel again. In this video, we are going to discuss about a statement which is based on trigonometry, right? And the statement says that the value of trigonometric ratios, like we have the sine theta, we have cos theta, tan theta, and the other three reciprocal of these three only. So the value of these trigonometric ratios will not change if we are increasing or decreasing, if we are changing the length of the side of the same triangle, okay? Depending upon the same angle. Suppose there is a triangle and on the basis of some acute angle, I am finding the trigonometric ratios. After finding the trigonometric ratios, if I am increasing or decreasing the length of the side of the triangle, and then when we are finding the value of the trigonometric ratios based on the same angle, the value of the trigonometric ratios will not change, right? So that we have to discuss, that we have to prove here. So yeah, let's start the video. And if you have any problem in any other topic of mathematics, please write in the comment section that, ma'am, I want this topic in your video so that I can make a proper video on that, right? So yeah, let's start the video, everyone. So let's talk about the statement of trigonometry. And the statement is that the values of trigonometric ratios of an angle do not vary with the length of the side of the triangle. What the statement is saying, so little, let's understand first. So if I am talking about this triangle, suppose this is a triangle ACB, where angle B is the 90 degree. So this triangle is a right angle triangle where angle B is equals to 90 degree. What they are saying, if I am talking about this angle A, so for angle A, what is the trigonometric ratios? That is a sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, or the other three functions, that is the cosec, secant, tan. If I'm talking about sine A, which is equals to perpendicular over hypotenuse, what is perpendicular according to angle A? So the front side of angle A is perpendicular, that is CB, and hypotenuse is the slopy side, that is AC. So for this triangle, sine A is CB by AC. What they are saying, do not vary with the length of the side of a triangle. What they are saying, that if I am extending this side, if suppose I am extending AC to Q, okay, making it larger, and I am drawing a perpendicular, from Q like this. If I am drawing this a perpendicular, so therefore this angle is equals to 90 degrees. So this point is B, let's take this point as E. So what they are saying, if I'm extending the lines and the angle is same, so for this bigger triangle AQE, what is sine A? Sine A is equals to QE over AE, that is perpendicular for triangle AQE. The perpendicular is QE and the base, the hypotenuse is AQ. So but AQ is a hypotenuse. So I'm talking about sine AQ. So what they are saying, that these two ratios, they are same. If I am taking the same angle and if I am extending the sides, if I am extending the length, or if I am decreasing the length, okay, the ratios will be same. They are same. So let's try to prove it. Okay, I think it's clear what the statement is trying to say. If you are extending the sides of a triangle or you are decreasing the sides of the triangle, for the particular angle, for this particular angle, for A or for angle C, for this particular angle, the trigonometric ratios values will be same. How? Let's talk about that. Okay. Just a second. Okay, so let's move to the next page. So this is the construction that you have to do. Now, what construction here you have done? So please understand. So first of all, you have drawn a triangle, right? You have drawn a triangle and the triangle is ABC. This is the first triangle you have made where angle B is equals to 90 degree. And then for particular that angle you have that in the statement, let's take this angle as angle A. Let's take that angle as angle A. We are talking about this angle right now. Okay. Now, what I have already told you, if I'm extending the line or decreasing the line. So what you have to do through construction, you have to take two points. So one inside someone on AC, and the second point you have to take on extending AC, point Q here. Second thing, what you have to do You have to draw the perpendicular from these two points. So first perpendicular from here and the second perpendicular from here. And the next thing what you have to do, join the base like this. So this point, name this point it as R. Okay, this point is B and take this point it as S. Okay, now let's talk about this. For triangle ABC, for triangle ABC, what is sine A? Sine A is perpendicular over hypotenuse. According to angle A, I am talking about triangle ABC only right now. For angle A, what is the perpendicular? The front side that is equals to BC, okay, over hypotenuse is what? The slopy side. And I'm talking about triangle ACB. So AC I'm taking as a hypotenuse, right? Now, for triangle APS, because these two, PS and Q, are the perpendicular, so they make the angle 90 degree with the base. So for triangle APS, what is sine A? Because we are talking, taking this angle only. Okay, angle should be the same for this. That is perpendicular over hypotenuse. And what is perpendicular in triangle APS? That is PS. And what is the hypotenuse? Is AP. Now, as per the statement, these two should be equal. But how? So let's do that. So let's take these two triangles only. So in triangle ABC and triangle APS, these two triangles are similar. How? First, angle A and angle A is common. Okay, these two angles are common. And angle PSA equals to angle AB, CBA. Why they both are equal? Because these two angles are 90 degree each. So therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle APS by which criterion? AA criterion. Okay, AA criterion. Now, when two triangles are similar, so their sides, the ratio of the sides are in proportion, right? So let's talk about that. So if I'm talking about ABC triangle, so we have to take perpendicular and base, but because these two triangles are similar, so let's take all the sides ratios. So PS over, because first I have taken perpendicular of, sorry, let's talk about, because first I have it in ABC, so let's talk about the perpendicular of ABC, which is BC over. What is the perpendicular of APS? That is PS. Equals to, let's take the base of these two triangles. So base is BA over AS equals to, you can write it as AB also, it's your choice. And then we write hypotenuse, that is AC over AB. Okay, so these, if the two triangles are similar, then sides, ratio of the sides are in proportion. Okay, this theorem you have already learned. Now, after this, if you will see from this, what you are getting. Now, let's talk, because we are talking about sine A right now. So, we want perpendicular hypotenuse. So, let's not talk about the base right now. So, let's forget this one. So, BC over PS, which is equals to AC over AP. AC over AP. Right? Now, let's do the cross. So when you will cross it, so let's AC take in the denominator and PS take it out in the numerator like this. Okay, after doing the cross like this, so what we are getting, BC over AC, that is equals to PS upon PS over AC. So it means these BC over AC we have here, BC over AC we have here, PS over AP we have here, PS over AP we have here. So it means for the same angle, the trigonometric ratios, that is the sine A, okay, the ratios are equal, the trigonometric ratios are equal, okay, if you are extending the line or if you are decreasing the line of the, if you are decreasing the length or increasing the length of any side of triangle, that does not put any matter to the value of trigonometric ratios, right? So this is for the sine A. You can do it for the cos A also and for the other trigonometric ratios. The value will be, you will get the same. And this I have done for the inner point that I have taken. You can also take it for this. So after that, if you want to take for point Q, so then you have to take triangle ACB, and second triangle you have to take as AQN. Okay, AQN for this. So first I have taken for this point, because this is the point on AC. So that's why I have taken two triangles ACB and APM. Now this is the point that is on the extended AC. So then you have to take, to prove the same statement for this point, you have to take these two triangles, and you have to do the same thing for that, right? So yes, we have proved the statement. So yeah, thank you everyone. Thank you so much. If you have any problem, then please write in the comment box that we have not understand the statement like this, right? So yeah, thank you everyone. Thank you so much.